सब्सक्राइब कीजिए हमारे YouTube चैनल शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन लीगल मैटर्स को और दबाइए इस बेल को ताकि आपको मिल सके हमारा वीडियो सबसे पहले और यह बिल्कुल फ्री है। रेडी स्टार्ट। मैडम डिप्टी चेयरमैन, आई वेलकम दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मेक ए फ्यू ऑब्जर्वेशंस ड्यूरिंग दिस डिस्कशन ऑन द फाइनेंस बिल। At this stage, therefore, it is better to use this opportunity to make a survey of the economic situation and find out what the present condition of the people is, whether they are satisfied, and if they are not satisfied, what the reasons are. I feel this responsibility is greater today when the American aid is likely to be reduced, and therefore we have got to stand more on our legs. When the plan was set forth, there were three sources from which we hoped to get finance for the plan, namely our own resources from the revenues, loans within the country through savings, and thirdly foreign help. The latter we need not discuss here. If we study the accomplishments of the plan and the resources that it has been possible to raise, we cannot deny that our expectations have not been fulfilled, and we have therefore to find out the reasons which have led to that situation. Here, incidentally, I would like to touch in a sentence or two the entire theme of the speech of Mr. Bhupesh Gupta. It is very easy to say this should be done or this could have been done from the position point of view, but I would like to ask him a question and he can reply to it later in some other speech, whether in Russia it would be possible for anybody, not in the debate in the parliament but even outside, to utter a single sentence against the government policy. In our democratic setup, we have allowed the people to criticize government policies. Even as Congress people, we are free to criticize the policies of the government. But the point is whether the doubts raised in the minds of the public by the people in the opposition who show their loyalty to a different setup would be conducive to create the enthusiasm that is necessary and the inspiration that is necessary to give their very best to fulfill the targets of the plan. This planned economy is really not a thing that will go successfully hand in hand with a democratic setup unless some other things are there, and they are proper national education to develop a national outlook. Unless these things are done as they are in other countries like England, unless that type of spirit is created in the country by all the people of all types of views not being allowed to create differences and doubts in the minds of the people, we cannot in a democratic setup have the success which we want, and we cannot fulfill our promises to the people. Without going further into that aspect, which really came to my mind as a result of the long speech of Mr. Bhupesh Gupta, I would like to make a few suggestions so that a proper attitude towards giving of one's best to the plan and to raise the national economy can be developed. I would like to make three or four points. Firstly, we have to see that we take steps to check corruption at any level, whether it is among the people in the public sector or among the officials. Then we have also to see that we give a proper type of education, rouse a proper spirit of service. We must also check the trends for inflation and also lay stress on austerity so that the people will feel that there is something at stake. I would not like to take much time of the house. The main problem in our country is the growing population, and in spite of all the efforts that are made to raise the standard of living and raise production, etc., the results are not as easily perceptible as they should have been. That is a separate problem by itself, but in spite of that, it is possible for the government to show better results if the government were to undertake immediately and see that some of the promises that are made, the acts that are passed, and the plans that are drawn up are properly implemented. I have been seeing this lacuna in the present position. Now the government have started a new ministry called the Coordination Ministry. It was very necessary because the plans of the different ministries sometimes were likely to go contrary to each other's aims. I do not want to go into details. For instance, take the question of the promotion of export. A commodity may be exported, but the price of that commodity in the country to the consumer may go on rising. Who is to see to that? Take tea, for example. It had to be exported and nobody was there to see whether there was enough tea for consumption in the country and what was the price at which it was available to the consumer in the past. Stop.